Hello, everybody, and welcome back to some more Super Robo Wars Z2 Hakai Hen. And this is one of the shorter episodes that. Well, it's one of the short episodes of this entire series. The thing is that. I said this in the last episode, but I was kind of fed up with a lot of the. with the stage, which is why I skipped almost every single attack animation. Now, I was close every single time I failed the stage, but then the Ardai gun, which appears as an ally for this stage, kept getting killed, and I didn't quick save enough. Oftentimes it was me rushing, and instead of pressing defend, I attacked instead, counterattacked instead, and I got killed because I took too much damage. So that's the case regarding that. I do know there's a part later in which you'll see me attack an invader with zero. You won't see the attack animation, and then it skips to the map where the invader is just destroyed. It was because I didn't press the recording button. Anyway, here is where you need to make sure you pick Ranka or Cheryl. Cheryl is the top one, Ranka is the bottom one. I believe in the other map, Ranka was on the top and Cheryl was on the bottom. So, pick the second choice if you picked Ranka before. If you picked Cheryl before, pick the top one. If you want to get the tornado pack with Alto. Anyway, opponents, you're doing logging, guys. Let's see. I think reinforcements will appear after you destroy a certain amount of them. Maybe they'll appear after a certain amount of turns has passed, but I just go in. Use focus, and I just go in. Let me think here. To get the SR point, you need to destroy all the enemies within 3 turns after the invaders show up, and the invaders will show up right when you destroy all of these guys. And what I recommend doing is spreading out, have all your units that have continuous action, and just spread them all out. Enemy units will appear on the bottom right. There's either 4 or 5 of them, but they all have like 13,000 health or something like that. Then Kuga does pop in, and I skip that animation. Kind of, it was by accident, but I didn't want to restart again to see that again. So just to see that little animation attack. So. Sorry, but I was just fed up with the stage overall. That's why, you know why. But like I said, the stage isn't anything too special. Just spread out your units. Here's what I would do. To the right of Alto right now is where you want to move all your units. And then, What you want to do is move your units towards these guys once they appear, because they'll be on the other side of the lake right there. You're going to want to move them next to Alto, then destroy all of the enemy planes, and then spread your units out when the invaders come. The Ardai gun and Dankuga Nova will appear as reinforcements. The Ardai gun first. You can send the Ardai gun anywhere you want, because once the other enemies besides the invaders appear, the Ardai gun will go right to them, so you can put it wherever you want. Dankuga will come in and attack one of the new enemies, and they'll stay damaged, so you can easily take one of them out with Dankuga after doing another attack with him. So that's just what I really wanted to say, in case I was interrupted, I suppose. This episode isn't long at all, which is why we're going over the strategy relatively early into the stage, because in case I'm interrupted by something, I might be gone for the entirety of the video, considering how short it is. Hope not, but that's just the case. A lot of my units now have continuous action. A crap ton of them, actually, which is good. It actually helps a lot in this stage. Like I said, the first time I was about to complete the stage, only 2 more enemy units left, and they killed our Ardai gun, which I This happened two times, by the way. Two times. I didn't quick save enough, and I was angry. I never heard really rage quit though, so I did finish the stage, but I was fed up with it. Fed up with it, as in I just wanted to get it done with as soon as possible. So you're gonna see obvious cuts, I suppose. I didn't try to hide it, but it's usually right after I quick save is when there would be a cut. And there may be some amount of background noise here and there in this episode. I don't really want to get too into it, so I'll have to say that. Anyway, Summon Night 5 regarding this one. Well, I know it's coming out this fall. I know the pre-sale of it ends in 2 days, and I won't have the money to purchase it by then to get the physical copy. I'll get a digital copy whenever I can. And regarding actually recording the game, I'm not sure I'm actually going to get it on my PSP. Because I know I can download it on my Vita and or PS3 or whatnot. I think if I can, I'll try to transfer it to my PSP. And if that works, from my PS3 to my PSP, and if that works, and then I'll do that, and I'll be able to record it from there. Worst comes to worst, if I really want to record it, how I have to record is that after I purchase the game, I'll have to I assume you guys can guess what I have to do. But I hope that I can do this the legit way and just transfer, download a copy to my PSP and be able to play it from there. I was mistaken earlier, the other day, when I was talking about Summon Night. I was just doing a little bit of quick research on it. The PSP, I was a bit outdated on my knowledge of the PSN store. It was shut down. It was shut down in Europe and the rest of the world first, before it was shut down in the United States. It was shut down in the United States in September 9th, 2014. However, I can still transfer games and whatnot to the PSP with the Media Go application, or my PS3 if I have one, which I do in fact have. And I was an idiot and I paused the recording, so I'm gonna go a little bit ahead of it. I'm gonna hope that I'm not too desynced. And well, because I paused the recording, I can't exactly talk about what's really going on, since I don't really know what's going on anymore. But It's a good thing I talked about the strategy overall in the beginning, but like I said, after the invaders appear, spread your units out to destroy all the invaders. Just do what I do, and you should be fine. So I guess I'll just talk more about Summonite still. But I'll end my commentary like right around where when the stage ends. So now that's just it. So yeah, it's unfortunate though. I'm confused whether or not they actually shut down the PSN store, because apparently this was released back in March. It says PSP firmware 6.61 was released. And I'm pretty sure it's been taken down. I'm not too sure on this. Although it doesn't really matter, as I said, I can just transfer from my PS3 to my PSP. Yeah, it's definitely shut down. Definitely. No wrong mistake in that. I suppose I should mention this. Once the new enemies appear, you're gonna want to move your units down there after you kill the invaders up here. I'd say try to finish off the invaders with your units that have continuous action, then move them down, and move them towards the new enemies. Did I cut at the wrong spot? It looks like I did. Sorry about that. It looks like I just destroyed some invaders. Didn't look like I did too much. Oh no. I can see right there that the Dar Daigun moved down there, so I assume Danku is down there as well. So it looks like I messed up. Like I said, I may be ahead or behind you guys. Let's see here. So let's see enemies here. Alright, what's the issue here? Alright, I found the footage that was supposed to be in the video that was not in the video. Okay. Alrighty then, I understand now entirely. Alright, I might have to redo this recording session. Looks like I'm gonna have to redo this recording session. This video part should be in there. Thank you.
is going to be a weird, like, issue where it's going to... Yeah, here it is. Alright, I found the footage that was supposed to be there, and that wasn't there. So, the issue that I was having, you guys aren't going to have. Alright? So, I'm horribly desynced with this. Jesus. No, the issue is whether or not I want to re-record this entire thing again. And I think I am, simply for quality's sake. I don't know. You know what? A lot of the things I did talk about during this short episode... Actually, yeah, during this short episode... wasn't necessarily really talking about what was going on, so yeah, I think everything should be fine, and I think I'll just keep talking until this video ends, because the new video is 2 minutes longer than this one. Actually, 4 minutes. That was 4 minutes of footage that was lost, I suppose. So I'll talk until this video ends, and then when this video ends, it's what's gonna happen. So yeah, anyway, regarding Summer Night. That's what's going on with Summer Night. So I may or may not record that. It all depends on a lot of different little things. I hope I will be able to. And if you guys do enjoy my playthrough of that, whenever I do get to that, I would recommend you guys actually purchase the game, because we all want more games that are consistent to Japan to come on over here for everybody to enjoy. I know, in a lot of cases where people... I think this is what I've noticed. I may be completely wrong on this, but if people rather have people from speaking other languages living in different countries rather have, like, at least an English translation of something, because more often than not, a lot of people learn English as a second language. I think. Because I believe in India, like, a lot of, like almost 100% of, like, university students or whatever, know English. It's, like, some crazy ridiculous percentage. I may be thinking of a different country, but it's something crazy like that. And people learn English all the time just by watching English movies and whatnot. So... sure, of course, it's not perfect. I'm sure they'd rather have it in their native language and whatnot. But... but I'm sure some people living in other countries would rather play English translation of the game rather than the Japanese version. But that's something I know. I'd rather have a game be translated so that everybody could play it, but that's nearly something impossible. But like I said, I may be misguided in my thoughts on that. Maybe people living in other countries rather have a game. They don't care whether it's English or Japanese. They rather just have it in their own language. Well, anybody would like that, but I'm just saying they would prefer playing in English translation rather than just a straight up Japanese translation. That's what I think anyway. Anyway, the video I'm watching is ending now, so I don't know about the video you guys are watching. So that's kind of funny, actually. So anyway, yeah, I know this stage is a lot of just things going wrong. All right, this is what this stage is. It hates me. I don't like it. It doesn't like me. So I'm just gonna. This is just it's one of those bad recordings that happen once in a while. This is what I'm gonna chalk it up to. So if you guys enjoyed this weird little episode here, thanks. But I'll see you guys again next time, whenever that is. Bye.